to another Art School video. Got our coffee ready, and got our paper, lights, our little mannequin here. So, sticking with the charcoal here, because it's just a very fitting medium for the Halloween season, so we're just going to keep on going with it, and do something today. See, this is getting really dark on this. You can see the charcoal that I'm getting off the blending stump here with the sandpaper. And this is why you do stuff like this. Nice clean blend with this thing. Sharpening your pencil, you know. But serves more than one purpose, obviously. So nice and clean versus, you know, the black end here. Let's see here. I don't know if I will need my stencil here. Don't even know if I'm gonna need this. You know, I was gonna do a straight edge. Your eraser, so just in case, because not everybody's perfect, we make mistakes. Excuse me, we don't make mistakes, we make happy accidents. Channeling our Bob Ross there. All right, get a little more coffee because it's early. Straight shapes or anything like that, because you know, you don't want this to look perfect. You want it to look kind of eerie, kind of creepy. So let's get started with this here. So I'm actually going to do this. I'm actually going to darken outside the hat here, just because of what I want to show you guys here in a little bit. So for reason, I'm darkening outside the hat is because he's got this lantern right here. So, I figure it makes more sense to darken around the hat. That way, the hat will be automatically lighter. So, we're going to darken everything around the character. character first. This is, of course, gone against my whole thing where, you know, try and start away from where your hand is. Always rules in art that are meant to be broken. Anybody tells you that there's some kind of rule in art, it's never, never set in stone. So, I'm actually going to go ahead and do this. Let's darken all this in here too. Might as well. Struggled with this a little bit the last couple weeks. It's one of the reasons why I didn't have a video last week, because I wasn't sure what to do with it, so couldn't think of anything. I had an idea, but I wasn't satisfied with it. I didn't want to come unprepared. And then something happened, I don't know, inspiration strikes, and all of a sudden here I am. Don't ask me. I can't explain the muses any more than the next guy. So, let's do this here. Get this in a little bit. Now, I'm not worried about darkening in this too much because, well, scale here, and all the details are going to get filled in later, or more details are going to get filled in later, I should say. Here, pull this all out. I always find it funny. It's like, yeah, you can see all my little fingerprints here. Don't know if you can see that, but yeah, there's like little tiny fingerprints right there. Oil in my hand, kind of soaked into the paper. Let me just start washing my hands really good right before I start doing all this. Alright, so now that I got that, fingers are already turning a little gray. Get some more coffee. I'm also going to do something over here, but I'll get to that. This is just I wanted to do the basic ideas around him. So let's do this first. Let's draw this in. Right. Normally speaking, I tend to draw the character's face first, but there's I have my reasons for this one. I'm not doing that. So. Go ahead and draw this thing in here. Draw in the lantern. side of the object going in. Just one line right here. One line right here. One line right here. And that's all for that there. Shadows mostly away from the light there. So, as you can kind of see, just I'm already kind of paying attention to where the shadows are based on this lantern right here, because obviously it's going to get much more, it's going to get much darker away from the light here. Dark shadow on the underside of the hat right here, and then dark back here. Shadow even right here under this guy's, on this guy's face, just because the brim of the hat is of course casting a shadow over him. And then trace this here. A little line for the guy's mouth there. A little shadow underneath. Collar, because he's working at night, so of course he pulls that collar up so it's nice and warm for him. There. Okay. Almost. Forgot that our little headstone was right there. But it's alright. We caught it. Not to worry. Let me do this with the block real quick. Just because you can get this a little bit darker than that. Funny enough, it just occurred to me that there's actually, you know, different shades, different tones of these blocks. You can actually get them lighter, you can get them softer, dark, you know, harder, darker, whatever. Either one, any one works. Just depends on what you're going for. Depends on what your style is. This is just the kind that I like. For you, what do you like? What makes you happy? Because, you know, we're not necessarily drawing, not always drawing for other people. Sometimes you just do this for your own benefit, something to keep you a little sane, help you relax. Because to me, this is extremely relaxing. It's one of the reasons why you don't always hear me talking during these videos, which I'm sorry, you know, it's just how I am. I get very focused when I'm drawing. I'm getting better about it. You notice I'm talking a little more during this video than I have in previous ones. To just sort of explain everything that's going on. Obviously, the far side of the hand is going to be a lot darker because it's away from that light. A little dark right here, just to get some of that nice shadow there. Now, an interesting thing here, you can actually go back and darken all this in, or you can even lighten it, whatever. Now we're going to fill in all this back here. Now all this, of course, is way off. All this is sort of in the distance here. So, of course, you know, I'm just not even going to have a whole lot of detail. It's just going to be basic shapes of the different headstones and things. So, absolutely don't need to do a whole lot to do this. You can if you want. If you're going for that much detail, then absolutely fill in as much as you want. Me, personally, though, I'm just going for very simple, very basic. Like, this guy's just kind of focus is mostly on him. Now, you can do a little bit of detail if you want. It doesn't take much. Maybe I'll put a little bit of detail on these front headstones here. But this is going to be a little bit darker than your background, naturally. And obviously, you want more dark on this side, away from that light, because for the most part, this drawing just has that one light source. Maybe I'll put some trees and stuff up here at the top, just to show he's working like almost completely in the dark, not even getting light from the moon. One of the things I like about charcoal is doing stone work, because charcoal almost gives the stone its own natural texture. You can almost leave it without any more detail. Almost. Sometimes you want to put a little more detail in, but it's almost perfect for doing stonework in a drawing. So we're going to do one more here, maybe another here. This one I'll do almost like a Celtic cross here. So I have this ring going around it here. Here, goes in here, and then comes up on the top there, and this is kind of what I don't know what it is about cemeteries. I love cemeteries. I don't know. Everybody thinks they're so creepy and stuff like that. Something about me is just fascinating. I love drawing cemeteries. It's almost like there's the artwork of the stone and the different headstones. And maybe a bit of a reminder that still alive, I guess. It may sound a little morbid, but that's me. I'm just a morbid kind of guy. And let's put some trees in here. Can't have a creepy cemetery without trees. Trees are one of those things you can just honestly let go with it and not even care about lines and stuff like that, as far as being straight, you know. Always makes me laugh, because it's like, I can't draw a straight line. Guess what? I don't need to. Don't draw straight lines. The further back these trees go, they're going to get lighter, you know, because they're kind of just fading off into the mist. So, I some blending, shall we? And you can almost leave it like this. Just depends on what you're doing, but I wanted to blend it out. Make this nice and smooth. Especially this guy. So with the larger blending stump, I'm just using it to blend out some of the bulky parts, you know, like I'll use it to blend the headstones here, stuff like that. But then later on here, right about now, but later on I'm going to get to the smaller stump and start doing all the little details, like on his face, hands, and such. Kind of closer together. There's a lot of empty space. Kind of funny that, like, you know, so if you're worried about these, you know, even though this is supposed to be crosses and headstones and stuff like that, you know, like, obviously I've got this cross here. Doesn't look very straight, doesn't look very symmetrical. There could be a very good reason for that, because headstones are made of stone, and stone may seem like it lasts forever, but it doesn't exactly. Especially when you get people that come in to cemeteries and start disrespecting stuff. I've been to several cemeteries where things were knocked over or whatever. Headstones broken, cracked, worn out. You know, they don't always last forever, especially when you're talking about really, really old cemeteries. There's a cemetery not that far from where I live here. So it's an old family cemetery. And, like, all the members of this family are buried there. But some of these headstones, like the most recent one that I remember seeing was from like the 1930s or something like that. It was a really, really old location, really old cemetery. Beautiful though. Imagine it'd be really kind of creepy at night. Still a beautiful place, and all the headstones in there, you know, falling apart. Some of them were even, you know, broken. I don't think it was necessarily like people intentionally doing anything like that, but it very well could have been. Some people just don't have any respect for places like that, they think. But just because everybody's dead in there, here. And that's just wrong.
high contrast from behind him and in front. This is all probably going to get a lot darker. Because it's obviously, and this is all going to be a lot darker because obviously it's away from the light. It's not a whole lot of light coming from the front here. Maybe this one's angled a little bit so it's catching it a bit more. But this is almost going to be, you know, hitting. And I'm going to put in some grass right here. Is and then as you get further back, you can just get smaller with less detail. You can go really light back here with that. You know, just get a general idea of where that is. This is again where you're just like. Just drawing little hash marks to create that the shadow of the grass. You can do them as short or as tall as you want, you know, because maybe this grass isn't quite tended that well. Like this guy doesn't necessarily do so much with the grass. He's just here to dig up the holes. And you could obviously do more than this. You know, there's sometimes rose bushes, things like that, from where people have left the bouquets for so long that they've grown into their own bushes. You can always do something, get creative with this. That's what I said. I love about cemeteries. They're always, there's a lot of history behind them. Not just the history with the people that live there, but you know, the place around it, the town that it was, that it's in. You can almost get a sense of what the community was like with the cemeteries. Example would be Savannah, Georgia. Go there, to some of the cemeteries. They got like Bonaventure Cemetery. A lot of character in that place. Here. Fill in some minor shadows right here with the hand. Let's blend this out some. And I'm going to go through and actually pull some of these up here. Smooth out some of this. Some of these grass blades. Glass braids, yeah. Smooth out some of these glass braids. Couldn't talk there for a second. And again, once you get some charcoal on your blending stump, you can almost use that to draw some of these distant blades of grass here. And since they're faded out, they don't fit perfectly with the ones that are off in the distance. Shadows from the wood texture. And kind of giving this guy some stubble there. Again, and then darkening in this. Maybe I'll darken it like the where his eye is. Right here behind him. He's just walking past this huge thing right here. Stick this in with the. There we go. Fits in so well like that. Small one here. Through the mist here. Darken up high here. Darken this out. Just bring it down some, just to add a little bit more of a contrast.
knots and stuff like that going around it or inside it. Whole lot of detail like with that, just draw in some small shadows here. Little tiny details make all the difference with these. And yeah. A little bit more of a shadow on the edge of the stone here, and a little here. And if you wanted to do something like, you know, even to put a little message here, you could write it in. Don't even need to actually write in the whole thing. You can actually just make some marks that look like it's a drawing, it's writing, but maybe it's just, you know, you can always, you can have an idea of what's in it, what it says, but if it's not, if it's not completely legible, that's fine, because like I said, these tombstones get old, worn. All you're doing is putting a little bit of texture. Maybe you can even draw in like a little tiny crack on the stone. Little marks on the edges show that it's worn out. Little things like that. Make it stand out. Make it look. Give it character. And then, let's straighten that out a little. Do it in a little more detail. And what I wanted to do was try something here. Let's see if this works. So, you've seen me do taking this and creating the shadows, but this, I'm going to do the exact opposite. I'm going to erase and create these highlights here. So, that's going to have a bit of a highlight right there. Just go very lightly up higher. Very lightly, just erase all around it here, and that's going to create this nice glow coming off of it. Doesn't have to be perfect, just has to be enough to, you know, show what you're doing. We were talking about. We're going to do almost exactly like what we did before with the mist. Just kind of go over it with this. Just to sort of create that. This is again where you gotta stretch your eraser out some, and to do that, because just like with your blending stump, you're picking up that all that charcoal, and eventually what you start doing is you just start smudging your charcoal rather than erasing like you want. And pulling this in here, let's get a little bit on him there, a little bit of that highlight right there. Okay. Here, see, yeah, just did exactly what I was talking about right here. Just not, it ended up just smudging instead of erasing. But no big deal. We just go back and we erase some more. I'm gonna highlight, get that highlighted even more, a little more. And a little bit here. Right here, just because I see those little fingerprints. I'm going to erase those fingerprints. And there we have our little grave digger for Halloween. So that was fun. That was different. Give me some coffee, which is cold now, because these videos are taking a lot longer. But anyway, so yeah, I'm also doing a little bit of research myself. I got this nice little book here that I found. It's actually all about like Celtic art, Celtic knots, and stuff like that. Hoping to learn something new here, because even as a lettering. This, I always found this interesting. I always love that kind of art, so something different, something new. But and maybe one of these days I'll be able to show off how much I've learned with that. So if you like this video, please hit the like button. And also, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified when I get new content up. I got a whole bunch of more videos coming out here. Obviously, still doing some more Halloween stuff. And if there's anything you'd like me to draw that you'd like to see me, show here, absolutely leave me a comment in the comments section. Let me know what you thought, and I'd be happy to hear from you guys. So thank you so much for watching. Have a good weekend. Happy Halloween.